Not a single congressman attended Monday's Senate constitutional amendments hearing scheduled by panel chairman Senator Robin Padilla. Padilla, who is pro-constituent assembly, had wanted to face off with congressmen pushing for charter change via constitutional convention. Padilla's counterpart in the House, Congressman Rufus Rodriguez, says he was raring to attend the Senate hearing but was notified at the last minute that it has been canceled.
We appeal to the senators to have an open mind, to think of the country, to think of the need to have more employment for our people and more taxes for our government, to be spent for programs for the people. The only way to do this is to have a constitutional amendment on the economic provisions of the Constitution.
Padilla's explanation, Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri advised him to respect their inter-parliamentary courtesy tradition.
Hindi ko naman inisip na magkakaroon ng problema patungkol doon kasi naka-hearing na po ako na may dalawang congressman sa tabi ko, wala naman naging issue. Gusto ko talaga marinig ng taong bayan. Pero siyempre, ako po ay bago dito sa pagiging mambabatas. Hindi kailangan akong sumunod sa mga bagay na sinasabi nila na tradisyon.
Padilla adds he was told by Zubiri that the two chambers will be tackling Chacha in an executive session instead.
Malungkot ako din natuloy kasi gusto ko talaga magkabakbakan eh. Oo, eto na talaga yung inaantay ko.
Zubiri justifies his call for an executive session on Chacha.
What I'd like to avoid is that there will be grandstanding by certain individuals. It is not going to be healthy if both houses are going to be fighting on this particular issue when there's still a lot of work to be done to help our country.
The Senate leader also denies that he is now more receptive to charter change.
We're not closing our doors for discussion. We're not closing our doors for that meeting. It does not mean that my position has changed. It only means that we want to discuss further with them.
Opposition Senator Risa Ontiveros, on the other hand, remains confident that Chacha will have a slim chance of passing in the Senate.
Minority Leader Pimentel and I are not alone in saying no to charter change at the moment.
On Monday, the National Economic Development Authority, or NEDA, announces the release of Public Services Acts implementing rules and regulations, which take effect on April 4. NEDA Secretary General Arsenio Balisacan says the law will now allow foreign investors to own airports, railways, expressways, and telecommunications. The law's author, Senator Grace Poe, believes the success of the measure lies in the hands of the concerned government agencies that would implement it. Senate President Pro Tempore Loren Legarda says it will encourage more foreign investments, improve the quality of goods, and create more jobs. Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva, meanwhile, says the full implementation of the PSA, coupled by the Foreign Direct Investments and Retail Trade Liberalization Acts, can bring in an estimated $10 billion worth of investments in the country. Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno, meanwhile, says he still supports charter change.
There are many, many more areas there which we can improve upon. Like, for example, ownership of the mass media. That's closed, right? Foreigners cannot own the mass media in the Philippines. That I am for opening that up. That will give you more opportunity, right? And also I'm for opening up educational institutions.
Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.